Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Trip Yang. I'm from NLC, New York City. Shout out to my people. And I have something on my mind. We keep hearing about how all these candidates running for president, that this is the most diverse field in history. And everyone likes to talk about issues important to immigrants and communities of color. But in behind the scenes, what's really going on is that these folks who are running these campaigns, there's a lack of diversity. We often hear that candidates are pale, male, and stale. It is even worse with campaign managers. And there's something to be said about that because the top folks on the campaign, the manager, the chief strategist, consultants, they're the ones who have enormous control over budgets and how campaigns communicate to voters. Too often, the diversity ends when the decisions are being made. And I'm concerned by this because it is our lived experience that really dictates how we run campaigns and how we shape our campaigns and how we talk to voters. So, with more and more evidence that diversity helps campaigns, how do we make it so that campaigns are more diverse and more effective, especially with the pivotal election that we all know is coming up? I think that we need to change the work culture of campaigns. That's not far off from the truth. Far too often, campaign staffers are asked to work 80-hour weeks, minimal pay, little to no benefits, often asked to relocate to a city and state, essentially putting their lives on hold. There's a lack of job security. You do a campaign for a month, a year, you win, maybe you lose, but every single time you always wonder what's next and how do I pay my bills? Now, the realization that some of us have come to in this industry, is that the staircase to success is broken. It is often somewhere where only the privileged can afford to climb up the staircase. We are taking our best talent and they're being exploited, they're being overworked, and they're moving on to other jobs. But we can change this pattern if we embrace a more progressive campaign work culture. Campaigns should strongly consider a minimum wage floor, health and dental benefits, severance pay, and paid time leave for their employees. It's not just about the money. It's also about being treated fairly in the workplace. Why haven't we had an independent process on many campaigns for folks to report grievances or sexual assault allegations? Now, I know that a lot of campaigns do not have the time or money to embrace all of these things, but if we just embrace some of these challenges and actually embrace some of these reforms, we can make campaigns a much more sustainable career. We can't stop there. We need to make sure that women and people of color are in a pipeline so that they're developed, they can grow, and they become leadership in top positions. Pay equity is very important. No matter whether you're on the entry level, mid-management, or your senior leadership, equal pay needs to come from equal work. Folks like us, we need to be in the room, making decisions, and getting paid that money. We can also learn from others. In professional football, a decade ago, they instituted the Rooney Rule that required every NFL team to interview someone who's a person of color for top positions. We can implement that on campaigns. Let's make sure that on campaigns, the top folks for these top positions, you interview at least one person who's not a straight, white, cis male. We know that in 2020, this is a critical time for us, and that as progressives, we need to make it count. I believe the journey is just as important as the end result. We've already seen some progress. A year ago, over a dozen campaigns have unionized to provide better work conditions for their employees. And we know that multiple presidential campaigns have already hired women and people of color in top leadership roles. I know from my own personal experience that there's challenges and opportunities. Earlier on in my career, I've had to rely on family loans, public benefits to get me through some lean periods. But I've had a family and friend support system around me. Just earlier this year, I was the winning campaign manager for a citywide race in New York. I know that not everyone has this luxury, and so it's incumbent upon all of us to fight for a more progressive work culture on campaigns. We're gonna make campaigns more diverse, we're gonna make it more effective, we're gonna beat Donald Trump. Yeah. All of you in this room, whether you work in campaigns or not, have a role to play. Your energy, your activism has already transformed the country. We need you in 2020. Imagine a room with the campaigns and campaign staffers as diverse as the room here in NLC and everything we can accomplish together. Thank you so much.